Welcome back to MAURO'S Films, and I made a promise to test this Canon FD 28mm 2.8 macro lens with these extensions that you see right here. But yesterday I had an accident. And are you ready for some macro shots with this lens?
Oh my god!
Maybe. Okay, it's intact. After the lens fell off my hand, I think that we are stuck on 2.8 all the time. I don't know what happened, I am not disassembling this lens now, but the lens is now on 2.8. So, because I had an accident 2 years ago on a ski resort and yeah, I had now to take out my screws and plates from my forearm, so it's really painy. Kinda thoughts review of this lens with these extensions. So, let's jump in. The 28mm f2.8 is aesthetically unremarkable. It looks fine, but it's not going to impress you with fancy paintwork or shiny metal. On Micro Four Thirds bodies, without the teleconverter, it will make a 56mm lens. The lens is entirely black, with a plastic aperture and focus ring. The green and white lettering is visible enough in most situations. On the last fall I damaged the UV filter, so now it doesn't came off easy, and worried to break something, so I will just leave it mounted on. The aperture goes from f2.8 to f22, but as I damage something inside, I'm stuck at 2.8. Like all FD lenses, the focusing ring is very smooth. The Canon extension tubes used are only mechanical with no glass inside, so they move the FD lens away from the sensor. In this test, I used the 50 and the 25 extension tube together. After that, I attached a SOLIGOR 2x teleconverter that will multiply the focal length of the existing lens by 2. The teleconverter have glass in it, so there will be a cut of the amount of light by 2 stops. Note that this is not a speed booster. And for the end, we have the dumb K&F Concept FD to Micro Four Thirds adapter with no optics in it. So that is how it looks when we attach all the extensions and converters. It makes a huge lens weighing 700 grams, more than my Panasonic G7. So I try some shots in bright sunlight, because with the SOLIGOR stopping down my 2.8 lens and the Micro Four Thirds sensor, I do not even know if I am at 5.6 or what. I will not try even to do the math, just play around to see what you can expect from this setup. In these first shots you can see the fully loaded Panasonic G7 with all the adapters and the approximate distance to shoot something with this setup. Notice that the high shallow depth of field of these setups makes the focusing a nightmare. Less than half an inch closer or away and everything is out of focus. The images shown are not graded and sharpened in any way to show you what comes out straight of the G7 in cine-like deep profile. Even if I'm not touching the lens or the tripod, the light breeze makes the whole image so wobbly. So this type of setup should be really used in a rock solid tripod inside, where there is no wind and you have a heavily bright illumination. I wasn't satisfied, so I removed the Canon tubes and left only the Canon lens and the SOLIGOR teleconverter. Now I had to move the object at least 40 cm at this point, but the image now is less shaky and the focusing is better. It was sunset, so I decided to finish this test and concluded that the extension tubes are a very well handy toy for adding macro capable shots, but adding such a weight to the G7, it makes a very unstable setup with only one tripod holding the G7. So the Canon FD 28mm and the SOLIGOR are enough for me. I hope you enjoy, and yeah, stay safe because gear accidents do not come cheap. And just hit a like for my forearm to recover, and yeah, see you soon, check my LUTS on my page, and I'm thinking to buy a drone, so stay tuned and see you very soon, bye!